Namaste and welcome to our program, Yoga for Unity and Well-Being, 100 Days Towards the International Day of Yoga 2021. This Sunday, we have with us Dr. Vishwas Manlik. He started his career as an engineering student in Pune and then began his own business. In the mornings and evenings when he would get time off, he would invest himself in the study and pursuit of yoga. Gradually, in 1978, for this noble cause, he began the Yoga Vidya Dham. Since then, there has been no looking back. In the year 2019, Dr. Vishwas Manlik was awarded the highest civilian honor for yoga in India, the Prime Minister Award for Outstanding Contribution to the Field of Yoga. Let's welcome him as he talks to us about yogasanas and practice of yoga, explaining how it can go from one level to another. When we begin the practice of yoga, we start from the foundation of yoga practice. Gradually, we can move on and develop in that very same asana and foundation practice different levels of mastery and expertise. How does this happen? What are the different steps involved? And how evolving is our practice of yoga so that one can pursue it all through one's lifetime and keep getting better and better at it? To encourage us, to motivate us, and to take us further into the field of yoga, let us listen to Dr. Vishwas Manlik ji. Namaste.
Hari Om. Welcome to all for this program. I'm going to explain some details about the process of asana. Asana is a very well known component, and most of the people understand that asana is yoga and yoga is asana. It is not 100% correct. Yoga includes so many practices other than asanas. But anyway, I am not going to discuss all those things. I want to discuss the practice of asana. And first, I want to mention that asanas can be practiced on different levels, which I am going to explain. You may be surprised to know that, because asana is a very known component. Millions of people are practicing asanas every day, and there are a number of asanas. All the asanas are explained in books and CDs and TVs and all that, and videos and all that. But I want to mention that every asana can be practiced on different levels, and I am going to explain these 6 levels of practicing asanas. And of course, the result also is different as per the level of asanas. And this I am going to explain with reference to Patanjali. Patanjali's text is a basic text on yoga, which most of the people know. Actually, Patanjali has not explained any particular asana in his text. He has given only 3 sutras about the asana. I'll explain a little bit and then we'll go, because my total theory is based on these 3 sutras only, and particularly the first 2 sutras. First sutra of Patanjali is Sthira Sukham Asanam. It means steady and comfortable posture is asana. So he gives 2 special qualities of asana: steady and comfortable, that is sthira and sukham. You can say this is a definition of asana. Asana is a position. We can call it posture also. So the position or posture which is steady and comfortable is asana. If it is not steady and comfortable, it is not asana. And it is steady and comfortable. Both things are essential. If the posture is steady but not comfortable, it is not asana. If posture is comfortable but not steady, it is also not asana. So this steadiness and comfort is very important aspect of asana. And in second sutra, Patanjali says, Prayatna Shaithilya Ananta Samapatti Bhyam. So he uses two words, Prayatna Shaithilya. That is relaxation with efforts. And in advanced level, we can say relaxations without effort also. And Ananta Samapatti is concentration on the infinity. In third sutra, Patanjali gives the result of asanas, that is Tato Dvandva Anabhighataha. It means after practicing asanas in such a way, as he has already explained in two sutras, the result is that your mind can go beyond the dualities. There are dualities, physical, mental. So one can go beyond this duality. So dualities will not affect the person. He can bear the duality with the equal calmness of the mind. So these are the three sutras of Patanjali. Based on these sutras, I have developed the different levels. So I'll explain all of them one by one. To start with the first level, but I give the number as 0, not 1. Because that is non-yogic level. Yes, asanas can be practiced on that non-yogic level also. And still they give some results. And what is that? Practicing asanas as exercise. That means with the fast movements and with the fast speed. Yes, asanas can be practiced like that. So that is what I call it level 0. It is non-yogic level. But still it is useful. I'll give the example of sun salutation, Surya Namaskar. If you practice Surya Namaskar one round in 1 minute, we can say it is a yogic way. If you practice one round in 5 minutes, it's still better as yoga. But it can be practiced one round in 15 seconds also. So one round in 15 seconds is a fast speed. So it is called exercise, non-yogic level. The Surya Namaskar can be practiced on all these three. But non-yogic level, it can burn the fats. So particularly when we want to reduce the fat in obesity program, we definitely teach the people to practice sun salutation 4 rounds a minute. 32 rounds in 8 minutes. Of course, followed by Shavasana. It works well. Likewise, all other asanas also can be practiced with fast speed. They can give some results. But the results are like the results of exercise. So it is exercise. So this zero level is practicing asanas like exercise with fast speed. Then we'll go to the level 1, Level 1 is practicing the asanas with slow speed and releasing, attaining and releasing with slow speed. No maintaining. So this is level 1, we can say the primary level of yoga asanas. And most of the beginners start with this level, it's okay. Now this type of asanas are very helpful for the people who have got the joint pains, because they cannot move fast, they cannot maintain the asana position. But a slow movement will help to improve the joint, to improve the weakness of the muscle. Because slow movement will definitely increase the blood flow, which will provide not only oxygen but glucose, oxygen, nutrients, everything. And that will remove also the end products from the muscles and the joints. So particularly arthritis patients, we teach asanas from this level only. So this is the primary level. Next level, we have to maintain the asana posture for a certain period of time. Of course, that period will depend on the comfortable condition. So asana can be maintained as long as it is comfortable. The maintenance time may vary. Rather, I want to say that it goes on increasing as you go on practicing. It should. So first we have to attain a posture with very slow speed, maintain for a certain period as long as it is comfortable, and release the posture with a slow speed. This is second level. You see, when we attain a particular posture, whatever the asana may be, then there is a stretch or compression in the muscles, skeletal muscles. But there is no movement. That means with this also, blood supply will increase as before. But there is no movement. So energy consumption is less. So we can get the better blood supply to the muscles, to the joints, without any exertion. Definitely this is advanced level as compared to the level 1. And normally we practice, we try to maintain it for a certain period. That maintenance time should increase as you go on practicing the asanas. That is the real yoga. So this is level 2. Now we'll go still further. So up till now I explained this sthira and sukham, steady and comfortable posture. And now we have to think of the prayatna shaithilya, as explained by Patanjali. And that is very, very important. Prayatna shaithilya is the most important tactics, we can say. Because Patanjali has explained, as I explained this sthira sukham asana as a definition, prayatna shaithilya ananda samabhattibhyam is a technique how to practice the asanas. So now prayatna shaithilya means, shaithilya is relaxation, and prayatna means efforts. This word itself is little bit difficult to understand. Because when we think of relaxation, we don't think of doing anything, just relax all the muscles, don't go do anything. So no efforts. But Patanjali wants to say that you have to take some efforts for relaxation. What are those efforts? Those efforts are relaxing the muscles. And that is what we do in Shavasana. Shavasana also is very popular asana, everybody knows that. So in Shavasana, we go on relaxing the muscles of different organs, one by one. So we take a position of Shavasana, close the eyes, and take our mind to every muscle and instruct that muscle to relax with the help of the mind. And that is followed and the muscle is relaxed. This is the best technique of Shavasana. And in particular in Yoga Nidra, many of you might have practiced Yoga Nidra as guided by my Guru, Paramahansa Satyananda Saraswati. In Yoga Nidra, the instructions are given to each and every organ to relax with the mind. Starting from the right hand thumb, index finger, middle finger, right side, left side, and so on. So this technique is Prayatna Shakti. And this is to be implemented not only in Shavasana, but in every asana. And that is what I mean by level 3. It means you have to attain a posture with very slow speed, maintain that posture for a certain time, and during that time, one should relax all the muscles one by one. You can follow the sequence given by Paramahansa Satyananda Saraswati, that is better. That is from the right hand ankle, right hand, right side, left hand, left side, back side, front side, and finally the facial muscles. So this is Prayatna Shaithilya. This is relaxation with efforts. And this is to be carried out in asana position. It may be Bhujangasana, Sarvangasana, Halasana, whatever it is. Of course, it is to be maintained as long as the position is comfortable. So it varies from person to person. But if you practice regularly with this technique, then one can easily maintain the asana for a long time, implementing the Prayatna Shaithilya. Rather, I can say, asana can be maintained for a longer time, provided Prayatna Shaithilya is there. If Prayatna Shaithilya is not there, then we cannot maintain for longer time. And if, even if you maintain the asana posture, the muscles are stretched or compressed, and that muscle fatigue will be there, and we cannot maintain for a longer time, we have to release the position. But with the help of this Prayatna Shaithilya technique, the muscles are relaxed. No stretch, no compression. And then we can safely maintain for a longer time also. We teach this technique in our regular class. Of course, it takes some time. It has got special techniques to teach also. For example, I can say the shoulder stand, Sarvangasana. We ask to maintain for 3 minutes in the primary course. It is a 1 month course, 1 hour a day. So all the students at all ages, they can maintain for 3 minutes safely, comfortably. That is important. In advanced course, we continue the practice and ask them to maintain for 5 minutes. Everybody can maintain. Because advanced course is for 2 months, 1 hour a day. In still advanced course, we ask them to maintain for 15 minutes, same asana, Sarvangasana, shoulder stand, maintaining for 15 minutes, but of course with the technique of Prayatna Shaithilya. Further advanced course, it is to maintain for 20 minutes. Further to that, it is to be maintained for 30 minutes. Just imagine, Sarvangasana, shoulder stand can be maintained for 30 minutes. Of course, it is different techniques are there to teach and all that. But basic technique is Prayatna Shaithilya. So Prayatna Shaithilya is very important. And it has to be practiced in all the asanas. As much as possible. But that makes you very comfortable to maintain the asana. The Patanjali's expectation is for comfortable posture. And for that he is giving the technique of Prayatna Shaithilya. And so it is important, useful. So this is a level 3. Here one has to attain a posture with slow speed, maintain for certain period with Prayatna Shaithilya, as long as it is comfortable, and release the posture with slow speed. What is the physiological effect of this Prayatna Shaithilya? You see, when we make the movements, they are made with the skeletal muscles. You all know very well. So skeletal muscles are stretched in asana position also. Because we take certain position and then becomes steady. But the position is something then different, normal. So some stretch and compression is there. So muscles are consuming particularly oxygen and glucose. But with Prayatna Shaithilya we relax them. But the position is not changed. Whatever the position of that particular asana, the position is not changed. Muscles are relaxed. So that stretch or compression is diverted to inner muscles of our body. All our inner organs are made up of muscles. Maybe the intestine, maybe the liver, maybe the heart also. All organs are made up of muscles. But in normal conditions, these inner muscles are not stretched or compressed. That stretch or compression is taken care of by the skeletal muscles. But here we are relaxing the skeletal muscles in certain position. So some organs are connected with that particular asana. There are different organs are connected with the help of different asanas. So those stretches and compression is transferred to the inner muscles of those organs. And when these organs are stretched or compressed, their blood supply is improved. They get better nutrients, oxygen, glucose. The end products are removed from those organs. So their function improves. So this is our experience also, because we are conducting yoga therapy center since last 30-35 years. So we ask the patients to relax the muscles. The Prayatna Shaithilya. I'll give the example, a diabetic patient. You know, for diabetes, the problem is of insulin. Insulin is generated by pancreas. And here the location of pancreas is. So we select the asanas which has got the effect on pancreas. And then ask those patients to relax the muscles, Prayatna Shaithilya, in those particular asanas. Let us say Ardha Matsyendrasana is the best for diabetes. So we take up the position, twist the body, so muscles are stretched. Then relax the muscles. The stretch will be transferred to the pancreas. And pancreas will improve its function. That is what is required in diabetes. That is why the asanas in diabetes or any other disease also, if they are practiced with Prayatna Shaithilya, then they have got an effect on that particular organ. If there is no Prayatna Shaithilya, then only skeletal muscles will be stretched. The inner muscles of the inner organs will be as it is, intact, no change, so no result. So some people tell us that I got a list of asanas which are given for diabetes and practicing since 1 year and there is no result. Why? Because they don't practice on level 3, they practice maybe on level 1 or level 0 or level 2 only. If they practice on level 3, we get the better results even in 10 days also. Because our naturopathy center, we conduct a course for only 10 days. So with the practice of asanas like this, in 10 days we get some better results. So definitely this level 3 is very important with Prayatna Shakti. Now let us go to the level 4. Level 4 includes the advantages of level 1, 2, 3. Because these all levels are on higher and higher steps, we can say. So for level 4, we have to make use of the fourth word of Patanjali, is Ananta Samapatti. Samapatti in a short, easy explanation is concentration of mind. Is Samapatti. And Patanjali has given Samapatti on Ananta, that is infinite. But here we just make some little bit modification. We ask the patient, and particularly I am talking about the patient, because this is useful for the patient. Level 4 is very useful for the patient. We ask the patient to concentrate his mind on his organ which is defective. Instead of Ananta Samapatti, we can say the organ Samapatti. This means that one has to practice the asana with very slow speed, maintain for a long time, relax all the muscles with Prayatna Shaithilya, and then concentrate the mind on his own inner organ which is defective. For example, diabetes, we ask them to concentrate on their pancreas. So normally we teach the patient about the pancreas, anatomy, physiology, everything. We locate the position of pancreas in his or her own body. So the patient is able to concentrate on his or her own pancreas. This training is given in the beginning, proper training with surface anatomy and everything. And then we ask them to practice, let us see, Ardha Matsyendrasana, same thing. So it's slow speed, maintaining for a long time, level 2. Relaxation of all the muscles, level 3. And concentration of mind on the pancreas. Because when one relaxes all the muscles, body is totally relaxed, mind is free. Mind is not engaged in muscular stretches and all that. So mind can be easily concentrated anywhere, but we ask them to concentrate on the particular organ. If there is some problem in digestion, we ask them to concentrate on stomach or small intestine, wherever the problem is. If the problem is for the liver, we ask them to concentrate on their liver. Problem is with the heart, we can ask them to concentrate on heart. And keep it concentrating as long as it is comfortable. That is always there. So this is level 4. Of course, Patanjali has not explained to concentrate on an organ and all that. He is explaining to concentrate on infinity. That is going away from the body. But we can utilize this technique, particularly for the patients, and it works quite well. So for the patients, practicing only asanas, and level 1 and 2 at the most, is not so effective. That is what our experience is. But if you teach these different levels, of course it takes some time. It's not so easy. But it works well. It gives very good results in shorter period. That is important. So proper training is definitely required. And that technique of training may vary from person to person, because everybody has got different physical and mental structure. Let us think of everything and then explain the things to the patient properly, and then teach under proper supervision. Go on observing the feedbacks of the patient at different stages. Because if it is overstretched, definitely something will be wrong. But if you take proper care, yes, the patient can come up to the level 4. And then he gets much more benefits, very good results of asanas. Now let us consider something about level 5, still advanced level, which is expected by Patanjali. Of course, this is not recommended for patient. This is not recommended for the beginner. It needs a lot of practice. But Patanjali says you have to concentrate on infinity. Infinity is, that means you have to get disconnected from your body. Up till now, for all these 4 levels, mind is fully engaged with the body. Maybe with the movements, maybe for the relaxation, maybe with the concentration on the organs. So mind is always busy with body. But Patanjali's final level of asanas, you have to get your mind disconnected from the body and take it to the infinity, ananta. Actually, ananta is, you can say, the Ishwar, as explained by Patanjali, or the supreme soul, we can say, ultimate reality, whatever it is, some concept. So first we have to teach this concept of ananta. Definitely totally different than the body-mind complex. So then mind is to be concentrated on ananta for a certain period. That prayer we have to manipulate. So this is ananta samapatti. It is practicable, but with a long practice of asanas in a very systematic way. The most advanced course is there where we teach this ananta samapatti. And here one has to maintain the asana for 30 minutes. Then only ananta samapatti is possible. So we have to select the asanas accordingly. I don't say that every asana can be practiced to ananta samapatti. Definitely not. But many routine asanas can be practiced up to level of samapatti. Of course, balancing asanas is not possible to maintain for a long period. But we select some asanas, teach them from the very beginning in steps. And slowly, slowly go on increasing the time, as I already explained in the beginning. Sarvangasana, from 3 minutes to 30 minutes. Like that, we go on increasing the time. And final stage, the students are in a position to maintain that asana for 30 minutes. Of course, initial certain time is spent in attaining posture, maintaining the perfect stage of asana, in Prayatna Shaithilya, relaxation, and then concentration on infinite. Of course, the whole teaching is with the proper instructions of the proper teacher. So we have to maintain this position of ananta samapatti. Guidelines are continued, instructions are continued, and the students are following the instructions. And then, of course, we ask them to slowly come back from the infinity to the body, different organs of the body, the position of asanas, all the muscles, breathing, and then slowly, slowly, slowly we ask them to release the position of asana. students experience very comfortable condition in this. It's a common asana. But a student says, we were more comfortable in asana than shavasana. That is the result. So they are feeling better and more relaxed in Ananta Samapatti stage, in asana position, than as compared with shavasana. So this is how it is to maintain. So physically and mentally it is relaxation. So attaining the last stage is definitely difficult. It needs a lot of practice, lot of training. But the first four levels and level zero also is definitely useful. And it's practicable also. Time span may vary depending on person to person. But definitely we can teach to practice asanas on different levels. And the result, as explained by Patanjali, Tato Dvandvana Bhighata, it is a mental result. Patanjali is not talking about the health and all that for the asanas. Because his total aim is yoga chitta vritti nirodha, controlling the functions of mind. And for that he is explaining all the techniques. Asana also is for that. So his main aim is to control the function of mind. The main aim of asana is to keep your mind away from dualities. Dualities are heavy and light, hot and cold, these are physical dualities. But I like this and I don't like this. This is mental duality. I want this, I don't want this. This is a mental duality. I have this, I don't have this. This is a mental duality. So for continuing the practice of yoga, one should go beyond these dualities in our life. And for that, Patanjali has explained the practice of asana, and for that he has given Sthira Sukham Asanam and Prayatna Shaithilya Ananta Samapatti. This is the stages which I explained to you. And this result is achieved. Students say this, we can go beyond the dualities. We don't feel anything good or bad for the duality. So this is a result of asanas. If you don't think of all these stages and levels, then it's very difficult to interpret the result of asanas as given by Patanjali. Just by practicing asana on level 1 and 2, or even 0, how it will be able to control the functions of mind? Definitely not. But why Patanjali has given? From this viewpoint, I have to study all these Patanjali's techniques, implement in the regular practice, step by step. And then we got the good results and we don't have any bad result. Which also I want to mention. Nothing is bad. When I started teaching like this, some yoga expert also started commenting on me. Why are you extending time so much? It can damage the health. But I am teaching this since last 40 years. And there is no bad result of it. Not at all. Everybody is enjoying this technique of asanas. Of course, it takes a long time, no doubt. Proper teaching and proper practicing is required. To reach Ananta Samapatti, I am saying. But to attain Prayatna Shaithilya is very simple. And concentration of mind on organ, so we can say, organ Samapatti. Up to that level is very simple. Only proper training is required, then anybody can go to that level. And we tried this with patients, they are not healthy persons. Healthy person can very easily go reach to that level. But the patients also can reach to this level. get advantage of this different levels. So after listening all these things, you also can think of about your own practice of asanas. Which level you are practicing? It may be there are some asanas you can practice on level 4, some asanas you can practice on level 3, some asanas you can practice on level 2, some on level 1 also. It's quite possible, but this is a developmental stages. One should go beyond the stage and go to the next stage. If you are practicing asana on level 1 throughout your life, you'll get some advantages, no doubt, but with very limited advantages. If you go to next stage, you'll get better and better results. As you go on attaining the advanced stages, you are going to get better and better results. So it is definitely useful to consider all these levels and try to improve our practice. Try to attain higher and higher levels. Of course, initially you will need some proper guidance, no doubt. But yes, anybody can go higher and higher. Time may vary. Time required for attaining the next stage may vary from person to person. But it is not impossible. Normally what happens, the people are more interested in practicing number of asanas. Everybody has got a limited time to practice. And in that limited time, one wants to practice more and more asanas. That is not good. Rather, I can say you should practice minimum number of asanas in the prescribed time what you have. Suppose you are practicing asanas for half an hour every day, 30 minutes. So initially you may practice maybe 15 asanas in 30 minutes. Okay, but what is the advanced level? It is not practicing 20 asanas in 30 minutes. 30 asanas in 30 minutes, that is not advanced level. That is a retarding level. Rather, you should practice, instead of 15, you should practice 10 asanas in 30 minutes. That is higher level practice. 5 asanas in 30 minutes, still better. So this viewpoint we must correct to get the better and better results of asanas. See, going behind the number of asanas is not so effective for physical health. Because when you go on increasing the number of asanas in a particular time, you reduce the time for a particular asana. So you are coming down to level, maybe from 3 to 2 to 1, maybe 1 to 0 also. And that is how Patanjali has explained everything properly. We must interpret the things and then bring in the practice. It is definitely true that Patanjali has not explained any particular asana. All asanas are explained in Hatha Yoga. In Hatha Yoga, the different asanas are explained. How to practice these asanas is not explained in Hatha Yoga, in that way. But if you combine these two techniques, Patanjali's and Hatha Yoga techniques, then this is the result, whatever I explained to you. Of course, there are some limits. Every asana in Hatha Yoga cannot be practiced as explained by Patanjali. But whatever is possible, practically, definitely we can implement the Patanjali's techniques with the Hatha Yogic asanas with certain limitations and get the better results. And asanas practicing as exercise is definitely not recommended in yoga at all. It is zero level. Of course, I explained in the beginning that certain cases zero level is important. That is a very rare point. Normally, we have to start from level 1 to level 5, step by step, in certain asanas. I definitely request all of you that you try to practice, get the result. Only thing you remember one word, that is comfortable, that is very important. Whatever you are going to practice, it must be comfortable to you, and comfort will depend on your personality. So practice with comfort and try to reach the advanced level of asanas and get better and better results. With this, definitely I conclude the lecture on asanas. I thank all of you. Hari Om.